Hey everyone, the name is Eric Thor, and today's poll is Do Opposites Attract? So feel free to use the link down below and cast your vote. Do you think an ENFP and an ISTJ can make a good match? For help with that poll, I have this nice video for you. Today we're talking about ENFPs and ISTJs and how compatible they are and how different they are and what their differences really are. Now, the interesting thing is if you compare two types, any two types, almost all types have at least 70% compatibility. That means on the whole, they are more similar than they are different. We are more similar to our opposites than we think. We exaggerate the differences between these two types, when in reality, it's not a 0-100 game. It's not that an ENFP is on one end of the extreme and an ISTJ is on the other end of the extreme. It's that both of them have some overlapping qualities, similarities, cognition, thought process, lifestyle, some things that just match and some things that match really well. So if you look at the ENFP-ISTJ relationship, one thing that makes these two types quite compatible is that they have a very high rating on balance. That means both of these types are able to balance the other one's energy. That means you are able to support the other one in things that they struggle with. So if an ENFP finds it very difficult to deal with certain matters, the ISTJ is there to pick up their slack. And in a way that is not too controlling, not too overwhelming, not too demanding. So that's a big pro for these two types. Now, if you look on the scale of needs, you can see quite a strong connection as well. 87% connection in terms of needs. That means when an ENFP needs approval or appreciation, an ISTJ is normally able to give that degree of approval or stimulation. Not too much, not to the much where the ENFP feels smothered, and not too little, not to the extent where they feel underappreciated. So 87% compatibility in terms of needs. Both are able to give each other more or less what they want. However, there are, of course, some differences, and we're going to go over those. The big conflict is in terms of lifestyle. When you look at these two types and their favorite hobbies and interests and activities, they are very, very different. That means ENFPs and ISTJs are opposites in the sense that they are very different in terms of lifestyle. So if you look at the letters, you look at the lifestyle. So you can see that the ENFP is on the average more extroverted than the ISTJ, far more intuitive and far more creative in their interests, where the ISTJ is far more practical. You can also see that the ISTJ has a bigger need for planning and control, and that the ENFP has a bigger need for freedom. And that's a big mismatch, because imagine you're going on a trip with somebody and somebody wants to plan every detail out of the trip and to make plans and arrangements, buy tickets in advance and all those things, set up timelines and deadlines and all those things. And the other type wants to just go there and see what they feel like. That's a conflict. So that's a big conflict in this relationship. Another thing is, of course, ISTJs, they are more on the thinking side, where ENFPs are more feeling, thinking, chameleons. That means ISTJs tend to favor discord and disagreement and conflict and competition, where ENFPs tend to want the mix of it. So sure, some competition can be fun, but at some extent it becomes too much and the ENFP will prefer to have some kind of collaboration, working together on projects. Now, if you go deeper into it, there's another feeling that's understanding, and that's just how well these two types understand each other's thought process and how much they can relate to one another. So when an ISTJ is talking, there is a high degree of mismatch and misunderstandings, because the ENFP will look at it differently and will think about it differently and will not understand how the ISTJ came to the decision they did. So in many ways, you will think of this type as an alien who has a completely different lifestyle to you. But you'll find yourself surprised that still, despite all your differences, this type is able to take care of you and to help you and support you in many surprising ways. And that's why it has, in the end, a 76% total relationship compatibility quotient. And that's pretty good. You know, if you look at it on the scale of extroversion and introversion, you can see that, yeah, okay, the ENFP is much more extroverted and the ISTJ is more introverted. You can also see that the ISTJ is more sensory and the ENFP is more intuitive. You can see that the ISTJ is far more thinking, and you can see that the ENFP is more feeling. you can see that the ISTJs on the opposite end in terms of judging and control, and ENFPs on the opposite end of perceiving, so freedom. So that means they are true opposites when it comes to perceiving and judging, but in the other lights, they're not necessarily true opposites. That means there are types that can mismatch a lot more in terms of extroversion and introversion. For example, the INTP will be far more introverted than ENFP, and there you'll have a bigger mismatch. If you look at it cognitively, more interestingly, what you can see is this difference, this collide on extroverted intuition versus introverted sensing. So that's where the biggest conflict is. Here you can see there is quite a degree of overlap here. There is overlap in terms of extroverted sensing. There's overlap on introverted thinking and extroverted thinking. There's overlap on extroverted feeling, being that both types favor extroverted feeling to a similar degree, which is not that much. Now, the big mismatch is on terms of introverted feeling, extroverted intuition, and introverted sensing. So here you can see that, okay, first, ENFPs, they value freedom, opportunity, and the pursuit of novelty. Introverted sensing types, they value stability, structure, and consistency of habits and of interests. So here you look at two completely different things. So now this does not have to be a bad thing, because when an ENFP goes through life, they're going to chase through a lot of opportunities, start on new projects, think about new ideas. And the ISTJ is going to be there to run the numbers and to provide ENFP with stability. So when the ENFP falls or drops the ball or cannot be at a certain place or something doesn't go as they intended, the ISTJ is usually well prepared and has thought about this eventuality happening and has come up with a contingency plan for it. So they're there to pick up your slack. Similarly, an ISTJ, if an ISTJ is caught unaware of something or doesn't really reflect on or notice patterns that are going to come up, the ENFP has usually the ability to improvise through that situation for the ISTJ. And in that sense, they have a high compatibility in terms of balance. With introverted feeling, is there's a bit of a problem, because the ISTJ is able to give some reassurance, but not necessarily the amount of reassurance an ENFP needs. You can see there's a small collide there, and feeling, an extroverted feeling and introverted feeling. You can see that similarly, for an ISTJ, the biggest problem is going to be extroverted thinking, because the ENFP has very weak introverted thinking. And so you'll see that these two types don't really overlap so well on those levels. The ENFP is not able to really analyze and see the problems and to pick up on issues in the ISTJ's plan. And so they're not really able to alert the ISTJ to these things. On extroverted sensing, there's a bit of a mismatch, because the ENFP is more adventurous and more open to go out and explore new things and to experience new things. And the ISTJ is not necessarily able to keep up with that. More likely, if you look at it, you can see that, yeah, this is the exact numbers. This is how different these two types are. You can see the ISTJ is more comfortable with introverted intuition than an ENFP is. You can see that the ENFP is more comfortable with extroverted intuition. You can see that the ISTJ is more comfortable with extroverted feeling. That doesn't mean that they are feeling types. It means that they are prepared to use extroverted feeling for the sake of the group and for compromise and for relationships, where the ENFP is slightly less comfortable with this because they are more individualistic. You'll see that the ENFP has a very strong introverted feeling. You'll see that the ISTJ has introverted feeling to quite some extent, better than a lot of types, just not to the same extent. So they're very different in this. So the ISTJ will really struggle to understand that aspect of the ENFP. Now, on the whole, like you see, there is a lot of overlap, and the types can be very similar. And you can see a lot of eye to eye with one another. True opposite does not exist. And ENFPs are not necessarily the true opposites of ISTJs. Perhaps ENFPs are rather the opposites of ESTJs or ESFJs. Now, that brings us to really the end of this video. How do you feel that ENFPs and ISTJs match? And what do you think about this relationship? And what do you think about the idea that opposites attract? And do you think this is a good match? Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you all in the next video.